Shameful, dangerous, and weak. Some of the words lawmakers from both parties are using to describe President Trump's remarks with the Russian leader Vladimir Putin today. President Trump failing to call out Moscow for interfering in our election. The Republican Senator John McCain putting out a scathing criticism of the Republican president. In his statement, it reads in part, "Today's press conference in Helsinki was one of the most disgraceful performances by an American president in memory. The damage inflicted by President Trump's naivete, egotism, false equivalence, and sympathy for autocrats is difficult to calculate. But it is clear," said McCain, "that the summit in Helsinki was a tragic mistake. No prior president has ever abased himself more abjectly before a tyrant. Not only did President Trump fail to speak the truth about an adversary, but speaking for America to the world, our president failed to defend all that makes us who we are, a republic of free people dedicated to the cause of liberty at home and abroad. American presidents must be the champions of that cause if it is to succeed." He goes on, "Americans are waiting and hoping for President Trump to embrace that sacred responsibility. One can only hope they are not waiting totally in vain." Meantime, the Republican Senator Rand Paul of Kentucky provided some of the only praise we've seen so far on the president's news conference today. He quoted the president and said he agrees he would rather take a political risk in pursuit of peace than to risk peace in pursuit of politics. And the reaction continues to pour in from both sides of the political aisle. Our chief congressional correspondent, Mike Emanuel, is live on Capitol Hill. Mike?
Shep, good afternoon. House Oversight Chairman Trey Gowdy was quick to say, quote, "Russia is not our friend. Russia attempted to undermine the fundamentals of our democracy, impugn the reliability of the 2016 election, and sow the seeds of discord among Americans." The Senate Foreign Relations Chairman, Bob Corker, says Vladimir Putin won the day.
I think he gained a lot. I mean, there's nothing. He gained a tremendous amount. It was almost an approval, if you will, a public approval by the greatest nation on earth towards him. And so he knows he gained a lot. I would guess he's having caviar right now.
And House Foreign Affairs Chairman Ed Royce is just out with a statement saying he disagrees with the president, too, saying there's no way you can compare the actions of the United States with Vladimir Putin. Shep.
Mike Emanuel, live for us. Thank you. During the buildup to today's meeting, President Trump set the tone by saying the news media is the enemy of the people and blamed the United States for Russia's aggression. Then today, Russia's foreign ministry, on its official account, retweeted the president. The Russian foreign ministry said this, "We agree." After President Trump tweeted, "Our relationship with Russia has never been worse, thanks to many years of U.S. foolishness and stupidity, and now the rigged witch hunt." Let's bring in Ambassador James Jeffrey, former Deputy National Security Advisor to President George W. Bush. He also served as ambassador to Turkey, Iraq, and Albania. He's now a distinguished fellow at the Washington Institute, which bills itself as a nonpartisan foreign policy think tank in D.C. Good of you to be here. Thank you.
Thank you.
In the main, your reaction.
Well, first of all, I was involved in many of these, quote, mistakes. And we did some things wrong in the 1990s and in the last decade with Russia. But all in all, we were trying to reach out to Russia the way we reached out, frankly, to China. The Russians, particularly Vladimir Putin as prime minister and as president, did not want to extend that hand or to return that hand. So most of the responsibility I would put on Putin. But to be sure, both sides made mistakes. The important thing is, and there I think President Trump did get that part right, it is important to talk to the Russians, and it is important to build up a coalition to deal with, among other things, China and some of the other threats we have. So far, so good. But what comes out of today, this is particularly worrisome because of everything we've been hearing for several hours.
What's particularly worrisome?
I know how Putin talks about things, and on all the important policy issues, nuclear weapons, Crimea, Ukraine, Syria, there's no indication that Trump gave any ground, that he made any concessions, or that Putin is happier today than he was yesterday. The problem is that Putin saw Trump as endorsing Putin's view Putin's claim that he had nothing to do with the hacking of the Democratic National Committee and the interference in the U.S. election. That's simply wrong, and most Americans are going to think that that's wrong, and that's a problem for the president.
He just tweeted, the president, seconds ago, and I quote, "As I said today and many times before, I have great confidence in my intelligence people. However, I also recognize that in order to build a bright future, we cannot exclusively focus on the past. As the world's two largest nuclear powers, we must get along. Hashtag Helsinki 2018. How were our interests served today?
If the president had said in his press interview exactly what he just said in the tweet and gone on to the next question, we wouldn't be having this conversation. Instead, he essentially attacked the belief or the reality that Russia was involved in this, and that has raised all of these questions to either cooperate with Russia, to compete with Russia, to have a conflict with Russia. You need the American people behind you. As you're reporting effusively today, he doesn't have that at this point, and he's got to fix that. I actually think the tweet is a step in the right direction. He's trying to say, I'm trying to move forward, forget about the past. But that means he has to leave the past alone when he answers questions, and he didn't today, and he's going to be a long time digging himself out of this, I fear.
Ambassador James Jeffrey, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Ahead, more reaction to President Trump's meeting with a Russian leader, the arrest of a Russian national for espionage trying to infiltrating a United States political organization. I'll speak to a foreign policy analyst who calls President Trump's comments on Russian interference indefensible. He'll explain why. And later this afternoon on Fox News Channel, Chris Wallace, the host of Fox News Sunday, has sat down with the Russian leader Vladimir Putin in his first interview following the summit with President Trump. Chris Wallace has told us it will be extraordinary television. It airs today, 6 o'clock Eastern, 5 Central, on Special Report with Brett Baer. We hope you'll be with him.